these four bullet points that we've got up here. And I'm just going to briefly talk you through what each of those bullet points really means. The first one being book talk. Now, we've probably got, sorry, this microphone can't move away from my mouth, so I have to hold my nose up here too. Some of these things will be quite familiar to you, and some of them will be very different and new. And I suspect this is one that's vaguely familiar to you. Book talk is really about a personal and a collective response to the text. It's not an analysis of the text. Oh, I can see an adverb over there. Or look at that adverb, it's in the middle of the sentence and that one's at the beginning. This is about a personal response. How does this text make you feel? And it's about moving through these three stages of response to come to some collective understanding of the text. So first of all, it's that quick response. How did it make you feel? Have you ever come across anything like this before? And we then push that a bit and say, well, why do you think that? What made you think that? What was it in the text? What was it in your life that made you feel like that about this piece of writing? And then we ask the question, well, does anybody have a different point of view? Because book talk is not about having a list of comprehension questions and working your way through them so that the children get the meaning you do. It is about reaching a meaning that you are satisfied with or not satisfied with, you're unsure about it and need to talk to more people or think more about it. But it is not about arriving at a point. And the book that we're going to use today is a classic example for me. We're using Blue John. I've used this book with children on my own. When I started talking about it with the team, I thought, oh, how didn't I see that? I never saw that in it. I never understood that from it. And a whole new world opened up for me about the book. The second thing that is in talk for writing is this notion of writer talk.